guys, Just Hockey here, back at you with another video. Today's discussion regards the Colorado Avalanche and what the plan is for them going forward after losing some key pieces in day one of free agency. Going into free agency this year, the Avalanche had the most prized UFA goalie in Phillip Grubauer, as well as other key pieces like Gabriel Landeskog and Brandon Saad. Landeskog, who was a top 3 free agent this year, was signed just before free agency started to a 7-year, $7 million AAV dollar contract to keep the first line of McKinnon, Rantanen, and Landeskog together. Unfortunately though, they were not able to re-sign Grubauer or Saad. Grubauer was a Vezina candidate this year and was a big factor into why the Avalanche had the success that they had. Grubauer was not able to come to terms with the Avalanche and ended up signing a 6-year, $35.4 million contract with the newest team in the league, the Seattle Kraken. With Grubauer gone, the Avalanche did not have a sustainable starting goaltender, with Devan Dubnyk also being a UFA, and the next best goalie in their system being Jonas Johansson. Joe Sakic wasted almost no time though in finding a replacement and traded for Coyotes goaltender Darcy Kemper. Although Kemper is a great goalie though, the price that was paid by Sakic felt more desperate than strategic like previous trades he has made so far with the organization. In exchange for Kemper, he gave up a 2022 first and prospect defenseman Connor Timmins, who will definitely become a top 4 defenseman in a few years. Although the price was steep though, it wasn't exactly a bad trade on the Avs' part. Sakic and the Avs know that their window for contention is now and that they have to be invested fully to target a Stanley Cup run. Trading futures and prospects is part of the sacrifice that they will have to make their team better immediately. For the Coyotes on the other hand, they get a great future defenseman in Connor Timmins and a first-rounder that will probably be in the late 20s, which is perfect for the all-out rebuild that they are going through. Grubauer was not the only player that the Avs decided to move on from, though. Forward Brandon Saad also decided to sign with another team and took his talents to St. Louis for a 5-year, $22.5 million contract. This deal, unlike the Grubauer one, was highly unlikely for the Avs to make, as they would have next to nothing in terms of cap space if they went forward. Saad was informed beforehand itself that a deal with the Avs would be unlikely, so there was no surprise that he signed with the Blues. The things that the Avalanche do have to do now, though, is like finding a replacement for Grubauer and Kemper, is finding a replacement for Saad. As of now, the Avalanche have not signed anyone like Saad yet, but will probably be looking for someone with a similar playstyle and a cheaper contract. The Avalanche's roster is entering their prime now, so they will be gunning for the Stanley Cup for the next few years while being pretty aggressive in terms of the moves that they make. Kemper is a solid goalie who has plenty of experience playing against the Avalanche and will probably be glad to play for them for a change, while a replacement for Brandon Saad might be announced later into the offseason. If they don't make a move like that to find a replacement, they might promote someone like Valery Nichushkin to take a spot in the lineup. Hopefully, the moves that the Avs are making are beneficial for them in the coming season and can provide them with a deep Stanley Cup playoff run. Anyway, that is it for this video. Talk to me in the comments down below on how you feel about the aggressive moves that the Avalanche have made so far, and if you think that the Avs are going to add someone like Saad to their roster in the future. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe, as it is free and helps my channel out a lot. Other than that, I will see you in the next video. Bye.